Hi you guys, I am back with another tag video. I haven't done a tag video in quite a while, but I wanted to do this tag video because I was so excited because earlier this week, Judy from It's Judy Time and It's Mommy's Life and It's Judy's Life, she tagged me in the beauty scenario tag, so I was pretty excited. I watched all of her videos on all three of her channels and we've become friends over the past couple of years. We were both pregnant at the same time, so I was pregnant with Max the same time she's pregnant with Juliana Bear, and so we've become friends. I was so excited. Thank you so much for tagging me, Judy. I'm really excited to do this video, so let's get started. Okay, question number one says, you have to get rid of all your foundations and you can only keep one high-end and one drugstore. Which do you keep? Okay, so I will do the drugstore, and I'm kind of embarrassed because this bottle is very, very loved, but this is my go-to drugstore foundation, and it is the L'Oreal True Match Lumi Foundation. I am obsessed. I am the color W3, which is nude beige, and I love this. I have combo skin. Some areas of my face are dry, some are oily, like my T-zone. So I like this luminous effect that you get from this. You can totally build this. It's not crazy expensive. It's more expensive, I think, for a drugstore foundation, but it's nothing like a high-end. But I have been using this for years, and every time I'm all done, I'm kind of sad. And I've tried so many different kinds, and this is like my favorite. And then as far as like high-end foundations, if I had to keep one, this is one that I actually started using recently, and it's the Bare Skin Bare Minerals foundation. So I have the foundation brush as well, and I have loved that. This is like the craziest foundation. If you haven't tried this, you need to try it. It's like the craziest formula, but it's so amazing. It makes your skin look incredible. It's so buildable. You can make it look really light as far as coverage, or you can make it heavier if you're like me and sometimes you get crazy acne or whatever going on. But this is like my favorite high-end foundation of the moment. Number two, you go in for an interview and the lady interviewing you has lipstick on her teeth. Do you approach the subject or ignore it completely? I liked this when Judy answered it because it's so much of her personality, I feel like, to just be like, oh, you have something in your teeth. I wish I could be more like that. I think it would depend if I felt really comfortable with this woman or not, but I think I probably wouldn't say anything because I would just feel kind of uncomfortable or kind of awkward. I don't know. I wish I was more like Judy and I could just be like, you got something on your teeth. But I mean, if she seemed nice, I think I would tell her, but if she seemed kind of like, ooh, kind of scary, then I don't think I would tell her. Number three, you're not feeling yourself and need a pick-me-up. Which lipstick do you put on to make yourself feel better? When I read this, or when I was watching Judy's, I knew exactly what I would answer, and it is MAC So Show lipstick. This is totally what I wear when I'm having a bad day. It's like a matte bright red orange, and it just makes your face look so much brighter, and it just makes me happy because it makes me feel like I'm special because I'm wearing a really bright lipstick that's just gorgeous. I don't know. Is that weird? I don't know. I love this lipstick. It's like my special occasion lipstick. When Michelle wants to feel special, this is what I pull out. Okay, number four says, you go back in time for a day to your teenage years. How would you do your hair and makeup differently? Okay, first thing, I didn't really wear makeup growing up. My mom didn't really support me wearing a ton of makeup, so I didn't wear a ton. I definitely did the white eyeliner thing because I was super trendy back in the day. But one of the biggest mistakes I did was tweeze the crap out of my eyebrows. I had the world's thinnest eyebrows because normally I have really, really thick eyebrows. And so it was kind of in style back then too, like in the 90s, to have super thin eyebrows. As far as my hair, I had really long hair like I do now, but it was like blonde. It was blonde. And it just doesn't go with me very well with my complexion and stuff. So I would definitely be like, Michelle, go get your eyebrows waxed somewhere. Don't wear white eyeliner and don't even try to be blonde because your hair is way too dark. Okay, this is number five. And it says, you ask your hairdresser for a shoulder length pixie lot haircut, but they hear wrong and give you a pixie cut. Do you A, smile, say thank you, leave, and call your mom hysterical? B, cry in the chair and things get awkward, or C, complain to the manager and demand a refund? Okay, I would definitely not do B. I wouldn't just sit there and cry. I'm not somebody to do that. I think I would definitely do A. I would smile and then just call my mom or my sister or my friend and just like cry. Or Brad, I'd probably call Brad. But my husband Brad would probably, after that happened, would make me call the manager made me complain because he's so good about like, stand up for yourself, get your money's worth. And I'm more just like, okay. More of a people pleaser in some situations. In some situations I stand up for myself, but in this kind of situation, I would just feel really, really bad. And then I would just think, my hair would grow back. It's not the end of the world. I can make it work, because I actually did have a really bad haircut when I was in Ukraine, like a really bad haircut, and there was nothing she could do. So I just had to smile and just go on with life. Okay, number six. Your friend surprises you with a 4-day city break and you have 1 hour to pack. Which do-it-all palette do you pack in your makeup bag? Gosh, that's a hard one. I think I honestly would just take... Okay, I had to quickly go to my bathroom and grab this, and I'm so happy. I don't know if this is cheating. Tell me if I'm cheating. But I would definitely take this set. It's the Bare Minerals All That Brightens collection set, so I think this is kind of like a palette. But I use all of these items so often. I can't even tell you. I'm obsessed with the eye colors. I'm obsessed with the blush, and it has the brush that comes with it. And I love the Marvelous Moxie lip gloss, as well as the eyeliner and the eyeshadows to die for. And I use these things day in, day out. I'm obsessed with this. So I think I would just grab all of this. Just big. Okay. So I don't know if that's cheating, because it's not like a one palette, but it's like a set of things that comes together. So that's what I would grab. Number seven says, your house has been robbed. Don't worry, everyone is safe, but your beauty stash has been raided. What's the product you really hope is safe? Of course, there's like a million things I think I could say for this, but I thought about it, and I think I would have to say this. This is my Hot Mama blush from The Balm. I am obsessed with this blush. I wear it every single day. It's just a beautiful, gorgeous blush that looks like, when you put it on, it looks like you kind of have like a highlighter on, kind of a bronzer, kind of a peachy blush, and it stays on all day. And not very many blushes do that for me. I don't know if it's like the weird chemistry in my cheeks or the oils in my face or something, but not many blushes stay on me. But this one stays on me all day, every day, and I love it. And I'd be so sad if this was gone, because I love it that much. Whew, getting sweaty. Whew, almost done. Okay, next question. I think this is the last one. It is the last one. Number eight, your friend borrows your makeup and returns it in awful condition. Do you A, just pretend you haven't noticed, B, ask them to repurchase it, or C, secretly do the same to something of theirs? Okay, who does letter C? I almost said number C. Who does letter C? That's like the rudest thing in the world. What kind of person are you? What kind of vengeful person are you? Okay. I would definitely say A, just pretend you haven't noticed. Obviously, if it was like multiple items and they kept doing it to me, I would stop giving them makeup to borrow or whatever. But I really liked what Judy said, how she just said makeup is makeup. Like, it's not that big of a deal. You can repurchase it. And that's how I feel. Unless it was like a $500 blush or something, which I would never buy anyway. But I think I just wouldn't say anything. It's not that big of a deal. So that is it for my beauty scenario tag. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I had so much fun doing it. Thank you so much, Judy, for tagging me. I was so excited. I was like a giddy schoolgirl when I watched her video and was like, ah, she said my name. So thanks for watching. I am tagging all of the mommies down below. So check that down below and see if you're tagged, because I want to see your version of the beauty scenario tag. So thanks for watching, you guys, and we will see you in my next video. Bye.